Gyfeillion, this has been a year like no other. Few of us thought a year ago, when the pandemic first hit, that 12 months later we would still be in lockdown, missing the loved ones we cannot be with, many of us feeling lonely and isolated working at home, others of us having lost our livelihoods. We have lost tens of thousands of our fellow citizens, each loss a heartbreak for family and friends. Businesses have struggled and are struggling, and public services have been put under unprecedented and unimaginable strain. Our children have lost the best part of a year of learning together, and we know that virtual lessons and the best efforts of families cannot replace the experience of learning at school. It has been a dark year indeed, but there have been lights in the darkness. We have been inspired by the selfless dedication of all our frontline workers in health and care, and also by the sometimes unsung commitment of all of those who've worked to keep our communities going and to keep them safe through this crisis. Shop workers, the van drivers, the police officers, too many to name. Many of us, like the team at Cafe Kutch in Pontyberem, volunteered to keep our most vulnerable neighbours safe and cared for. Many of us reconnected to our communities and reflected on what really matters to us. And now there is light at the end of the long tunnel. So, as the vaccine programme is rolled out, restrictions are gradually eased, this is the time for us to ask ourselves what kind of nation we want to be. As the COVID crisis has highlighted long-standing injustices and inequalities, with women hit harder than men, black people and people of colour at greater risk of both economic and health harms, and our poorest people and communities bearing the brunt, we have to ask ourselves, is it enough to build back better? I think not. Better than what? With one in three of our children living in poverty before the pandemic, we can surely do better than that. But just better isn't good enough. It is time for a reset. It's time for us to set out in earnest on the journey to build our nation of equals, a community of communities where all are valued and all can contribute, where our most vulnerable are supported and our children and our young people thrive. The question before us, the people of Wales on May the 6th, is who we choose to lead us on that journey. We can dismiss the Conservatives out of hand. That party in Wales is more clearly now than ever a minor branch of the Conservative and Unionist Party in England. The Westminster government they so enthusiastically support is hell-bent on undermining the powers of our Senedd, withholding promised resources unless they are to be spent on Boris Johnson's pet projects, and frankly, treating the Welsh government with contempt. They are allowing candidates to stand in the election who are completely open about wishing to see our Senedd abolished, trampling on our fledgling democracy in their stampede to shore up the union. It is inconceivable that we would place our trust in them. What of Labour? Well, it must be said in fairness that this would have been an incredibly tough year for any government of Wales. In terms of managing the crisis, they have done better when Wales has ploughed its own furrow, less well when they have towed the Westminster party line. But we should not judge them on this year alone. When the election comes in May, they will have had 21 years, a lifetime, to deliver the transformation that Wales needs, and they have failed. One third of our children live in poverty. They have been content to provide childcare only for children with working parents, and they preside over the meanest offering of free school meals on these islands. The economy in our valleys communities has not recovered from the ravages of Thatcherism, despite two decades of a Labour government telling us again and again that this was their priority. And our rural communities remain fragile, over-dependent on tourism, and with our farming sector facing an uncertain future, partly though not only because of Brexit. Labour has lost its way in terms of its values. Who could have imagined that the party of Keir Hardie and Aneurin Bevan would abandon its targets to end child poverty? Labour ministers are content to blame Westminster for the impact of the cuts in public spending on our communities. Yet they refuse to even ask for the powers needed to defend those communities. They have never explained why they won't ask, for example, for the administration of benefits to be devolved, as it has been to Scotland. No, whatever Labour once was, whatever it stood for, they have had their chance and they have failed. On May the 6th, we need to elect a government that will work for Wales, a government that can lead us on that journey to build our nation of equals, a Plaid Cymru government. We will place before our fellow citizens in the coming election the most ambitious and radical programme of government possible. Nothing less will do. And at the heart of our programme of government will be our commitment to rebuild our economy in such a way as to deliver an equal nation and a green nation. It is impossible to overstate the peril to jobs and businesses that we face as the pandemic crisis comes to an end, and with it, government support for business. Plaid Cymru have already published our ambitious recovery plan. We will invest £6 billion, creating 60,000 new jobs in the short term. Projects will include building thousands of new social homes, retrofitting 100,000 homes to the highest environmental standards, and creating work in the care and childcare sectors to relieve pressure on the struggling care sector and help our children catch up on their lost year. We cannot afford to let a whole generation of young people fall behind, as has happened in previous economic crises. So we will guarantee a job to every 16 to 24-year-old not in educational training, paying the real living wage. We will continue to provide support to those businesses in the sectors hardest hit, like hospitality, tourism and culture, to ensure that they survive until such time as they are able to trade normally. We will make ending poverty a core goal for our government, cutting across all portfolios. We will work with all public bodies in Wales and with local government to develop binding, deliverable anti-poverty targets for each institution, and we will monitor the delivery of those targets closely. We will transform the existing Welsh benefits system, ensuring consistent entitlement criteria and easy access. And we will pay the real living wage to all those working in the public sector in Wales. And we will at once demand from the UK government the devolution of the administration of benefits as recommended by the Senedd Committee. We are under no illusion that it will be challenging to persuade this right-wing unionist Conservative government to grant that devolution, but we will do everything in our power. And we will find a way to deliver our commitment to pay £35 a week for each child to the poorest families. Again, we know this will not be straightforward, but we will find a way. We are clear as a party about the purpose of our economic policy. To create wealth, yes, but also to ensure that it's fairly shared. To build our national prosperity so that we can afford the world-class public services that we all deserve. And to contribute to building a better future for our planet by placing active decarbonisation at the heart of our actions to build our economy. To deliver on these purposes, we will create a new freestanding agency, an economic development agency with a difference, Prosperity Wales. We will task Prosperity Wales with developing our economy in such a way that opportunities are created fairly across our nation, with access to opportunity for all. There will be a strong emphasis on a spatial approach, focusing attention where it is needed most, on valleys, communities and on rural areas. And there will be an equally strong emphasis on addressing the patterns of historical discrimination that have led to the chronic injustice and inequality in the way our economy has functioned. There will be a focus on growing local businesses, on enabling export and on improving productivity. We can no longer tolerate the current situation that sees Welsh people working harder and longer but producing less because of lack of investment, lack of skills and lack of leadership. Prosperity Wales will focus strongly on the promotion of research and development, enabling existing businesses to innovate and decarbonise, and creating an environment where entrepreneurship will thrive. We will expect Prosperity Wales to take risks. For there can be no innovation without risk. The foundational economy will be supported and strengthened, And we will support businesses to bring the manufacturing of key items that we need day to day back home, developing just in case rather than just in time supply lines. We will enable local procurement on a massive scale, spending as much as possible of the Welsh public pound here in Wales, and supporting businesses to build the supply chains needed where they don't yet exist. Cultural and creative industries will be supported for their economic as well as for their central importance to our national life. The promotion of fair work will be at the heart of the Prosperity Wales agenda. It will be at the heart of all Prosperity Wales will do. Working in partnership will be key, not the kind of lots of meetings but no accountability partnerships that have characterised too much of Welsh Government practice under Labour, but real, meaningful, engaged partnership with all parties contributing and holding each other accountable. We will develop the Prosperity Wales model in close consultation with the business community. Universities and further education colleges will be vital, both in terms of research and development and in terms of delivering training in the skills that will be needed for the economy of the future. The experience, local knowledge and local leadership of local government across Wales will be drawn upon to inform and help shape all that Prosperity Wales will do. And of course, Prosperity Wales will work closely with our proposed regional development bodies for Arvor and for the Valleys. Guided by the remit letter from the Minister for the Economy, Prosperity Wales will be led by a board made up not only of the best minds from the business world, but also experts in tackling inequality and in decarbonisation. An economic development agency with a difference indeed. Does dim am heiaeth bod ein cynllun ar gyfer ein economi yn uchelgeisiol, ond mae yn un a gallwn ni cyflawni. Byddwn nhw'n galw am pwerau benthyca pellach gan y Llywodraeth yn San Steffan. Ond os nad ydyn nhw'n cytuno, mi ddawn ni o hyd i ffyrdd arall i ariannu y buddsoddiad angenreidiol hwn. Mae ein genedl yn llawn o pobl dalentog, pobl galluog. Rydyn ni wedi bendithio a cyfoeth naturiol. Does yna dim byd anochel am y ffaith bod cymaint o'n cyd-dynasyddion yn byw mewn plodi a cymaint o'n cymunedau wedi cael eu galw, gadw yn ôl. Mae ein cyflwr yn canlyniad uniongyrchol o benderfyniadau gwleidyddol neu diffyg penderfyniadau gwleidyddol. Mae rhaid i ni wneud penderfyniadau gwahanol a mae rhaid i ni wneud nhw nawr. Dim ond Plaid Cymru sydd ar gweledigaeth yr uchelgais a'r angerdd i adeiladu y genedl deg, werdd a llywychus, cenedl sydd yn cyfartal, y cenedl dyn ni gyd eisiau byw ynddi. Gwyddwm o fiwn pwerau presennol y Senedd, y gallwn deithio'n bellach ac yn gynt o lawer ar ein taith tuag at y genedl honnol, os mae Llywodraeth Plaid Cymru sydd yn ei arwain. Ond heb y pwerau normal cyffredin, pwerau sydd ar gael i cenedloedd annibynnol normal cyffredin, ni fyddwn ni'n gallu cyflawni popeth sydd angen i wneud. Mae angen i ni cymryd yn lle fel genedl cyfartal ymhlith cenedlaethau eraill y byd, yn rydd i dilyn yn llwybr a hunan, i gwneud yn penderfyniadau yn hunan, a ie, hyd yn oed gwneud yn camgymeriadau yn hunan. Nid oes yna un genedl wedi llywodraethu genedl arall yn dda, a nid oes un genedl a dywysodd annibyniaeth wedi gofyn i fynd yn ôl. Mae egni a brwdfrydedd sydd yn cysylltiedig â'r mudiad annibyniaeth yn ysbrydoliaeth ac yn acos am optimistiaeth. Mae mwy a mwy o pobl yn gweld bod annibyniaeth nid ond yn bosibl ond yn angenreidiol. Ac er bod yr egni a brwdfrydedd o fiwn y mudiad yn hanfodol, mae cyflawni annibyniaeth yn dibynnu ar ethol llywodraeth a fydd yn ymladd drosti ac yn gwneud hi yn bosibl. Felly, gadewch i ni matio'r egni a brwdfrydedd hwnnw a defnyddio i cyflawni llywodraeth honno, Llywodraeth Plaid Cymru. Cyfeillion, spring is almost here. The sun when it shines is that bit warmer. Fragile blooms are tentatively showing their faces in our gardens and our hedgerows. There is a sense of hope and a sense of change in the air. We need to make that change. We are not ashamed to say that we love our nation and the communities that shape and sustain our lives. And most of our fellow citizens feel the same way. Our task in the next few short weeks left to us is to convince those fellow citizens to take that love into the polling booth. Campaigning under these circumstances will not be easy. Who knows if we will be able to get out on the doorsteps, listening to and talking with our neighbours, campaigning in the way that we do best. But one thing that the pandemic has taught us is that there are many other ways to communicate too. So let's make those phone calls, send those emails, talk to people on Facebook, Zoom if we must. Do whatever we can to convince our fellow citizens that change is possible and that it needs to come now. Now is the time to vote for a better future for our children and our grandchildren. To vote for a prosperous nation with opportunity for all, an equal nation and a nation of equals. Now is the time to vote for Wales that works for businesses, large and small, and for all those who make them succeed. Now is the time to vote for Adam Price to be our first minister, leading a Plaid Cymru team that can lead us on that journey to the nation we want to be. Now is the time to vote for Wales, to vote Plaid Cymru.